Question 20. Use the substitution u equals cos x plus 1 to find the exact value of e, the integral of e to the cos x plus 1 sine x dx. So as always with integration by substitution, we're going to start by differentiating our substitution so that we are able to replace the dx here. So du by dx is equal to the cos x will differentiate to be minus sine x. The 1 will differentiate to be 0. Let's make dx the subject now. So I just moved the dx up there and the minus sine u down there, minus sine x down there. So I'm going to plug that in to my integral. So the dx becomes minus du over sine x, which is going to be helpful because that's going to cancel this sine x out here. So that's going to be nice. That's going to make my life easy. The only other thing I need to worry about is the e to the cos x plus 1, which in the u world is e to the power u. So this integral is just going to become minus e to the u du. Let's just change our limits though. So they're in the u world as well. So when x equals 0, u is cos 0 plus 1, which is 2. When x is pi over 2, u is cos pi over 2 plus 1, which is 1. If you wanted to, we could swap those limits around so the bigger number is on the top, and I can change that minus e to the power u to be a positive e to the power u. You don't have to do that, but you can if you want to. Substituting my, doing the integration now then, e to the power u will integrate to be e to the power u. Substitute the top limit in to get e squared. Substitute the lower limit in to get e. And that is my answer, e squared minus e. Or you could, if you like, factorise an e outside. Either way, those are the exact, that is the exact value of that integral. Question 21. Figure 4 shows a sketch of part of the curve with that equation. We need to find region R. So we're going to be integrating our curve. So integrating 2e to the 2x minus xe to the 2x dx between the limits of 0 here and the upper limit there, which we don't know what that is yet. We do know that's when y is 0. So that's going to be when 2e to the 2x minus xe to the 2x is equal to 0. To solve that, let's factorise the e to the 2x outside, which will leave me with 2 minus x on the inside. And that can only equal 0 if this is 0, which would be when x is 2. So that's my upper limit. Right, now this integral, I can see that this is going to integrate pretty easily. But this, I'm going to need to use some by parts on that. So let's integrate that separately first. So let's integrate x e to the 2x. Let's just do that here. I'm going to say that u is equal to x, because that's going to differentiate easily. I'm going to say that v dash is e to the 2x. So u dash is 1, just differentiating the x. V integrating the e to the 2x will be e to the 2x divided by 2. So applying the by parts formula, this is going to integrate to be u times v. Minus the integral of u dash times v. And now I can integrate that second, a half e to the 2x. The e to the 2x will integrate to be e to the 2x, divide by 2. So it's going to become 1 quarter e to the 2x. So we have just shown that this integrates to be this. I still need to integrate the first term though. So we've got the 2 e to the 2x, which is going to integrate to be 2 e to the 2x divided by 2 by the reverse chain rule, which is just going to be e to the 2x. So I've integrated the green part. Now I need to take away the integral of the yellow part, which was the a half x e to the 2x minus a quarter e to the 2x. Just dealing with those brackets, we'll have a minus a half e to the minus x, and then that will become a positive there, the minus minus. And our limits are 2 and 0. Substituting the 2 in, we'll get e to the power 4 minus a half times 2 times e to the power 4 plus a quarter e to the power 4. Substituting a 0 in, we've got e to the power of 2 times 0 minus a half times 0 times e to the power 0 plus a quarter e to the power 0. E to the power 4, the half and the 2 will cancel out, so we'll get minus e to the power 4 plus a quarter e to the power 4. These will cancel out. Then the second bracket, we've got e to the power 0, which is 1. A half times 0 will just be 0, plus a quarter e to the power 1, so that's plus a quarter. And then the 1 plus 1 quarter is going to be 5 over 4, so my answer is 1 quarter e to the power 4 minus 5 over 4. And there we go, that is in the desired form.